It is the 28th of the 8th, 2013. This is your Radioactive Reality. Let's go and get started on ENE News. Nations across the Pacific are fearing impact from Fukushima. Many expecting cancer will increase in Pacific Rim. Japan exporting their environmental problem to the ocean. And the leaks continue. They continue. Arnie Gundersen, radioactive plume to impact West Coast in a year. Not going away after it hits. Likely to only get stronger. Fukushima will keep releasing contamination for years to come. Decades and decades. Must demand officials test fish and make data public. And what you got to think about is, where does Iran come from? And if that water just keeps getting more and more radioactive, it's not just going to be a coastal problem. Study: fuel materials introduced into Pacific Ocean via drains of Fukushima plant resulting in potentially serious contamination of marine environment. Now they're referring to number 3 that blew up and sent core fragments and everything else up into the air and into the ocean, and the things that go on with that. Japan professor compares cesium-137 release from radiation disasters. He's saying Fukushima at up to 77 quadrillion becquerels, and Chernobyl was at 85 quadrillion. But Fukushima releases are ongoing. These numbers are drastically low. I'm sure Fukushima is tenfold to Chernobyl by now. You got to remember there are 3 reactors several times larger than Chernobyl ever wanted to be. The coming fallout. Experts now fear a massive reservoir of Fukushima contamination about to reach the Pacific Ocean. Slow seeping buildup of a second catastrophe. Workers can't say when or how they can stop the flow. And that's this big cauldron they've built with their impervious wall, and that on a riverbed, and it's filling up. They're saying it's like 10 feet from the surface as far as the water level, the water table at Fukushima. Some good news. Vermont Yankee is closing permanently. Embattled nuclear plant will be decommissioned in 2014 when current fuel cycle ends. They had the license to operate up to 2032, and it's just not economically viable for them to continue operating this nuclear power plant with all the ongoing. And this is exactly the same reactor as in Fukushima, so this is good news. Nuclear experts concerned about water flow reversing due to Fukushima underground ice plan. Even more highly radioactive liquid inside reactor buildings to enter aquifer? Question mark. So if they freeze up the water around, that's just going to have to back up, isn't it? So it's going to spread out to more areas. Warnings about the foundation of Fukushima reactor chambers have been compromised. Groundwater rising fast, now just 10 inches from the surface. And these very heavy nuclear reactor buildings on a muddy slope is not a good combination. In an earthquake-prone area, to boot. Nuclear official TEPCO made Fukushima plant into a machine for generating radioactive water. Runoff from molten atomic core, now in groundwater and ocean, and he's saying air cooling should be used. Japan Times, extreme contamination of Fukushima reactor buildings most likely mixing into aquifer, reveals TEPCO. Bloomberg, this could flow downstream to Tokyo and present a big risk? Question mark. You got to remember, they're burying all this crap in Tokyo Bay. They're burning all this stuff in open incinerators, the tsunami debris, and they're burying it right into Tokyo Bay. So Tokyo's just as contaminated as the entire northern part of Japan. Water with nuclear fuel coming up from the ocean floor off Fukushima coast? Question mark. Tokyo professor, 150 quadrillion becquerels of cesium-137 once in basements. Double Chernobyl, getting close to total fallout from every atomic bomb test in history. And these are the official numbers, not the inflated reality numbers, I'm sure. Maybe outputting from seeps in seafloor, I don't know. Where did these 3 coriums go to when they left the building? And they are in the environment, sitting down on the bedrock, and where's that water seeping out to, out into the Pacific Ocean? And it goes on and on. Fukushima leaks much worse than authorities will admit. Disturbing questions confront Japan as leader visits Middle East to push nuclear. They are exporting their nuclear business wherever they can, including North Korea. The Japanese are a part of a massive non-consensual experiment on radiation exposure. Everywhere now is radioactive. We can't escape it, says Fukushima local at the beach. They've got a video on that. And again, it goes on and on. Over to Fukushima Diary Daily News. Nuclear Regulation Authority, it's impossible to transfer all the water from the flange-type tanks to new tanks. You got to remember these 350 tanks with the rubber flanges that they moved onto concrete pads without any tie rod in it, without any metal rod to help support the pad. So all these tanks are full, leaking, settling in this soupy mix. You got to remember they're in the cauldron, and the problems continue, and they got nowhere to put this stuff, and you know where it's going to end up. You know where it's all going to end up. Seawater contamination does not decrease even with the impervious wall. Of course, that corium's in the environment and they can't hide it anymore. That's why all these stories are suddenly coming out. Leakage might have been occurring since this July. No countermeasures taken. Now, these are the tanks again. I'm sure they've been leaking since before July. That's just when they've come out with these numbers. And finally, over to Informatable. Japan still has not responded to South Korea's request for radiation data. On August 14, officials from the South Korea formally requested their Japanese counterparts provide them with details of the situation at Fukushima Daiichi in the wake of multiple reported leaks into the Pacific Ocean. Specifically, officials transmitted some 20 questions which requested information related to the amount of leaked radioactive water, radiation levels, results of radiation measurements, and planned response measures. For nearly 2 weeks, they waited for an official response. On Saturday, they submitted another request for Japan to supply the data. As of Tuesday, South Korea officials acknowledged that they have received none of the information requested. The Japanese government claimed it is difficult to prepare the technical data requested quickly. The insanity continues. It just continues. That's about all I have for you today. Of course, if I missed anything, please attach a comment or provide your video below. Enjoy while you can, everybody. Thanks.